Okay, good morning and welcome to today's Finance Committee meeting. My name is Councilmember Daniel Drum and I'm the chair of the committee. We're joined today by Councilmember Adrian Adams, Councilmember Robert Cornegie, Councilmember Andy Cohen, Councilmember Keith Powers, Councilmember Steve Matteo, and Councilmember Barry Grudenchik. And today we will be voting on four items, Resolution 286 and three Article 11 property tax exemptions. First, we have Resolution 286, sponsored by Councilmember Torres, calling upon the state to grant the city broad authority to use the design-build method of construction. Design-build is a method of capital project delivery in which one entity works under a single contract to provide both design and construction services. The primary benefits of design-build are that its use substantially lessens the likelihood of delays and cost overruns, which we all know firsthand currently plague many of the city's capital projects. In 2016, the Citizens Budget Commission concluded that the city would have saved as much as $2 billion over 10 years if the state had authorized the use of design-build. On the BQE triple cantilever project alone, the city expects to save taxpayers as much as $113.4 million and shave 2 years off the construction time. Despite these obvious benefits, New York City is generally barred from using the design-build method due to a variety of restrictions in state law. While in this year's state budget, the state did grant the city authority to use design-build contracts for three specific capital projects, such authority was extremely limited. We still lack broad authority to use design-build on the projects of the city's choosing. While design-build would be useful in many areas of the city's capital program, from transportation projects to NYCRA repairs to DEP programs, we are voting on this resolution today in the context of school construction. This resolution was first heard by the committee in April of this year at a joint hearing with the Committee on Education. It was heard as part of a package of bills to support the recommendations made in the Council School Siting Report called Planning to Learn, the School Building Challenge. The report highlighted existing overcrowding and the challenges related to planning for new schools, called for greater accountability in the school planning process, and provided recommendations to help expedite new school construction. To that last point, one recommendation outlined in the report was that the state grant the SCA design-build authority so it could build new schools faster and cheaper. In order to help the SCA build new schools faster and cheaper, and to help the city save valuable time and taxpayer dollars in many other capital projects, I urge all of my colleagues today to vote in favor of Resolution 286. Next, we have the land use items. The first is 501 West 143rd Street in Councilmember Levine's district in Manhattan, which would provide a full 40-year Article 11 tax exemption to support the preservation of 37 units of affordable co-op housing. The second is Morningside Apartments, also in Councilmember Levine's district, which would provide a partial 40-year Article 11 tax exemption to support the preservation of 49 units of affordable rental housing. The third is 9 Argyle Road in Councilmember Eugene's district in Brooklyn, which would provide a full 40-year Article 11 tax exemption to support the preservation of 12 units of affordable co-op housing. Both of the council members are supportive of the projects in their respective districts. Those are all of today's items, and if there are any questions, please raise them now. Okay, seeing none, I will ask Billy Martin, the committee clerk, to call the roll.
Roll call, Committee on Finance. Chair Drum.
I vote aye.
Cohen.
Aye.
Cornegie.
Aye.
Grudenchik.
Aye.
Adams.
Aye.
Moya.
Aye.
Powers.
Aye. Clinton, I just want the request to be added to 286 as sponsors.
Matteo.
Aye.
My vote of 8 in the affirmative, 0 in the negative, and no abstentions. All items have been adopted by the committee.
Okay, I'm going to ask the clerk to hold the vote open for about 10 minutes or so until other members can join us. Thank you.